Hey yo, here we are, famo, at the very end of our Logic No Pressure train. Roll it. Welcome back to the channel, everybody. Channel's name is The Third Ernest. I'm Ernest Adiano the Third. Y'all guys are the Third Family. If you're new here and you're not subscribed and you like what you see at the end of the video, consider subscribing and becoming part of this little family we got. Bottom right hand corner, subscribe button, notification bell, hit that shit. But here we are at the end of our Logic train, ladies and gentlemen, and I've been impressed so far. I like the album a lot. I definitely like it more than the most recent projects that he's put out. It seems more genuine, it seems more authentic, and it seems like going out of the game with the same producer and the same style and the same sound that you came into the game with. So dope that he gets the opportunity to do that and then he executes on that opportunity. But we got the last track. Follow your boy on Instagram and on Twitter at The Third Ernest, just like the channel. Links are down in the description below. And we got Amen. Let's get it.
This right here for anyone who ride with me. Heard me laugh, watch me cry, did time with me. In the game, not just on the sideline with me. I'm a sinner, I'll admit it, but I got God with me. Been to hell and back twice just to feel the burn. If your ass don't fall down, then you'll never learn. True. I just wanna be the best that I can be. I just wanna be me, even if it's not naive. I thought acceptance from others, it would set me free.
Yeah, all right. Just speaking his truth, dog. God been to hell and back twice just to feel the burn. And if you never drop, if you never fall down, you'll never learn. And that shit rings true for anything in life. If you've never experienced pain, you're never gonna understand what it feels like to experience pleasure. And in the same way that the people who have experienced pain. If you grew up with money, silver spoon fed, you're never gonna know the importance because you've never known anything different. The people who rose from the bottom to the top, they're gonna know what it feels like to not have it. So one, they're either appreciate the money more. Two, they'll work harder to get it and keep it. Or three, there is no three. It's just one of those two, actually. And he says, I just wanna be the best me that I can be, even if that sounds naive. And if it is naive, then so be it. I'm just trying to do me, dog. You know what I'm saying?
Beats me, even if it's not naive. I thought acceptance from others, it would set me free. But it didn't, no. Oh no, it never did. No matter what I said, no matter what I get. Sometimes people make me question if I wanna live. We call that a dark day, such a dark day. But I know tomorrow gon' come, it gon' come my way. And I know in my heart it's gon' be a better day. It's gon' be a better day. That's why I came here to say Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
It's dope. The rhymes on this track are not like the best, most technical rhymes ever. Like this is this one syllable rhyme scheme, day, say, give, live, like that's not gonna make me fucking, oh shit, that shit fucking got me going. So technically in that aspect, on the technical side, this songwriting is obviously not gonna be the best on the album. But from what he's saying, he's just reaffirming everything that the rest of the album has said. For years, I've been trying to be somebody else. For years, I've been trying to fit whatever I thought a successful rapper would do and say, and it was never me. Because it was never me doing all these things in order to get approval from people who don't even matter, they like weighed on my soul and my mind, and it never turned out to be what I thought it should. And the beat gives me the same feeling that the last beat did, like we're at the end of the album, so we're just celebrating. The song is just like, it's not a hype song, it's not a hard ass like bass line, it's not a trap sound, it just sounds light and happy and celebratory, because we're at the end of his career on the last song on the album.
Amen, amen, amen. Amen. We make plans and God laughs. Feel like the older I get, the quicker time passes. Some people live in the past, others live in a flash. Giving your bitch a perfect life, it could be gone in a flash. Texting on your way to.
Yeah, now we're spitting. He like brought the voice down. He's like, all right, let me get in my bag one more time. Let's do a fucking final lap. He said, I feel like the older I get, the quicker the time passes. And it honestly does feel like that. Me and Logic were roughly the same age, but that's what it feels like. Especially once you hit that 30 mark, you're like, damn, where did all that fucking time go? He said some people live in the past and some people live in the flash, like drinking. And he said, even your picture perfect life could be gone in a flash, bro. That's a bar. Like your picture perfect life, everything, the picket fence, everything you ever wanted, one instance could be gone, like in a flash, but literally like a picture, you like the flash of a camera. Dope. And on the album, Under Pressure, he already used a line like that. He said, life ain't picture perfect. We use the negatives to develop. Like we use the negatives in life, like the down moments in life, to develop and grow. But like literally negative, like negative picture. And then you develop that film to bring it into the positive picture.
Giving your picture perfect life, it could be gone in a flash. Texting on your way to work and now your brain's on the dash. We all powerless, especially people think power lasts. I ain't cowardice, but sometimes wish I live behind a mask. Cause facing this world is such a rigorous task it. Feel like the world wanna put me in a casket. Wish I was stronger, wish I could just get past it. If you feeling how I'm feeling when this song play blasted, if you feeling how I'm feeling when you hear this, let me get it.
That's dope. That's a perfect way to go transition into the hook. If you're feeling like I'm feeling, if this message resonates with you, let me get it. Can the church say amen? And he said, sometimes I wish I could live behind a mask. I ain't cowardice. Just sometimes facing this world is like a rigorous. It's a difficult task. And it's ironic that he says that sometimes he wishes that he could live behind a mask, when in previous songs, he's like, I tried to live behind that mask. I tried to make these people happy and put on this facade, and it like got me depressed and it got me anxiety. And you know, it was just one of the darker times of my life. So even though it's a rigorous task to face the world with no mask on, front and center, like, that's the way you gotta do it.
Amen, 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 amen. Right here for anyone who ride with me. Heard me laugh, watch me cry, did time with me. In the game, not just on the sideline with me. I'm a sinner, I'll admit it, but I got God with me. Came up on Section 8 and I made it, yo mom, look. Writing these raps in a Louis Vuitton rhyme book. Hey. I never thought I'd make it out the hood and now I'm shook. I finally made it out my hood, everybody look. I'm across the street.
Again, like, the rhymes aren't like the most technically, like, aren't hard hitting, because there's not multiple syllable rhyme schemes, which is normally what we're used to in this day and age. The slant rhyme between mom look and Louis Vuitton rhyme book, like, that's dope. And the rhyme in terms of like making it from Section 8 to like look at me in my designer Louis Vuitton rhyme book where I write all my shit down, that's been said before by many artists. But I feel like every artist says it because of how rare it is to do that, how rare it is to get out of like Section 8 low income, like below the poverty or at the poverty line. Like, it's hard to make it from that life and make it all the way to the tip top of like stardom. So I feel like every time a rapper says that, yeah, it's been recycled and it's been said before, but they have every right to say that and have every right to like to reflect on the fact that they've made it that far, because it doesn't happen that often.
I'm across the street waving when the grass is green, hating on how far I've come. I don't give a damn, Gina. This is celebration with no invitation. This the last one that I'm done. Permanent vacation. Only place.
Hold up. That Gina line, is that from fucking Martin? Yo, 90s sitcoms like Martin and the Jamie Foxx show and Fresh Prince of Bel Air, they went hard. But that line distracted me. I'm gonna rewind a little bit.
Come, I don't give a damn, Gina. This is celebration with no invitation. This the last one that I'm done. Permanent vacation. Only place I felt I belong was Babel Station. Cooking crack for my generation. Now it's time to conclude the incredible true story and transformation. Salutations.
Yo, that fucking transition into obediently. People told me that this isn't really a song, so I might just like skim through it right now. But like, yo, he said, I'm across the street waving where the grass is greener. Like, yo, look, like, cause he said, I made it out. Like, look, the grass is greener on the other side, because anything is greener than where the fuck I came from. And he said, the only place where I feel like I belong is Babel Station. And that's like the space station from the incredible true story. Like, he made that entire thing up. Like, that's his utopia. And then right after the Babel Station, he says, now this concludes the incredible true story and transformation, salutations. And the name of the album that Babel was part of is Incredible True Story. But yeah, I'm gonna skim through this last one real quick just to see what we got, just to see what people are talking about. Beast fire. I like that clap, because it sounds like it's in a very echoey like cave, and it sounds like liquid dropping, like individual drops dropping into a pool in this vast ass cave. That's the clap is clean right there. It's tight.
This is
logic.
But surely my right to having more than enough is canceled if I don't use that more to help those who have less. I owe the very profit I make to the people I make it from.
Damn. Motherfucker's spitting, dog. He said, my right to have more is relinquished or will be canceled if I don't use that more that I've gathered from the people that I've gathered it from, which is normally the people with lesser. It's fucking crazy. It's like Jay-Z said, I can't help the poor if I'm one of them, so I got rich and gave back to me. That's the win-win. God, that's a fucking bar. Every time I recite it, every time I hear it, I can't help the poor if I'm one of them, so let me make it out and give back to me, because I can't help it if I'm one of them, so I might as well just keep giving it back to me. That's the real win-win. Fire line. Even if it's fucked up, it's fire.
Any public man owes his position to the public. That's what I mean when I say I'm your obedient servant.
I'm your obedient servant. Like, that's the way people sign, like, salutations, not salutations, like, sincerely or with love. your obedient servant, because if you're someone who has it in a position of power over other people, it's my responsibility as a smarter person to do all that I can for the ignorant. And because it's my responsibility to do all that I can, I end up being their servant. That's dope.
A free man owes to the world's slaves all that he can do for them. And what is to be done is more, much more than good works, Christmas baskets, bonuses and tips, and bread and circuses. There is only one thing to be done with slaves. Free them. The measure of progress, as we understand it, is the measure of equality enjoyed by all men. We can do something about that.
Yo, who thinks like this? Who talks like this? How smart and how, like, intellectual and reflective do you have to be in order to even come up with the shit that he's saying right now?
These words, the way they looked at it, we're lucky. And they're right, we're lucky to be alive, but only if our lives make life itself worth dying for.
Damn, we're only lucky to be alive if our lives make life itself worth dying for. Whew, that's a fucking speech bar right there.
Unless we put the gift of life to the hard employments of justice. If we waste that gift, we won't have anywhere to hide from the indignation of history.
If we waste that gift, we won't have anywhere to hide from the indignation of history. God damn. This motherfucker's spitting some knowledge, son.
Tomorrow's democracy discriminates against discrimination. Its charter won't include the freedom to end freedom.
This might be harder than the whole fucking album, dog. He said tomorrow's democracy discriminates from discrimination. Oh my fucking God. He said its charter won't include the freedom to end freedom. Bro, tomorrow's world, you will not be free to end freedom. Holy fuck. I'm assuming the speech is like from the Jim Crow days, since he just brought it up right there and said the auction block is out of date and, you know, talking about Jim Crow South in the United States. If it wasn't for that Jim Crow portion, I would think that this speech is relevant today. And that's crazy to think that.
Where the racist lie is acceptable, there is corruption. The race haters must be stopped. The lynchings must be stopped.
Yo, you know what I just thought about? It's fucking crazy. That logic was like, his entire career was scrutinized because of his mixed races and how he would talk about race and talk about, like, racists and things like that. This whole shit right here is like an uplifting message to anybody who's willing to listen, but also like a big fuck you to anybody who ever talks shit about the fact that he wanted to talk about race. He's like, oh, you have a problem with that? Let me end it with a fucking 6-minute speech all about race in the Jim Crow era. Crazy.
It's in the people's power to see to it that what makes lynchings and starts wars is dealt with, not by well-wishers, but by policemen. And I mean good policemen. Oh, for several generations, maybe there'll be men who...
And I mean good policemen. I literally just said like this, if it wasn't for the Jim Crow, I would think that this was today.
But we should deny such men responsibility in public affairs exactly as we deny responsibility to the wretched victims of the drug habit. He must be deprived of influence in a people's government. He must be segregated, as he himself would segregate the colored and Semitic peoples.
Yeah, I'm a strong believer in the First Amendment, and I do think it's people's right to be able to say whatever the fuck they want as long as they're not inducing violence. But just because it's your right doesn't mean it's your right into public office with that type of mentality. And that's where it's our right to determine that. Because if you can keep racism out of public office, then someone who's racist, they have no power and they just seem so infantile. You know what I'm saying?
It calls for the doing of great deeds, which means the dreaming of great dreams. Giving the world back to its inhabitants is too big a job for the merely practical. No one of us will live to see a blameless peace.
Bro, this motherfucker just said, giving the world back to its inhabitants is too big a job for the merely practical. Who in the fuck comes up with that sentence? And it's such a hard ass sentence too. Like the practical thinkers are not gonna be the ones to make this world right. It's the people who think impractically. It's the people who have bigger dreams than just your normal practical dreams. Yeah.
Our children's children are the ancestors of a free people. To the generations, the fight is worth it. That just about means that my time is up. When my time's up, I remain as always, obediently yours.
God damn, that whole speech, dog. And it's hella dope of logic to put that in there, knowing that entire 6-minute speech is gonna overshadow his entire album. He is the sacrificial lamb by putting that type of thing in there, especially knowing that hella people are gonna jam this album because it's his last. Even with the criticism that he's received in the past for talking about race, he said, fuck it, I'm gonna double down on my last song on my last album. And he knew, there's no way he didn't know that that whole speech was gonna overpower everything about the album. If you told me to recite a line from you on the song that we just heard before the speech, I couldn't even do it because I already forgot about it because I'm just stuck on this motherfucker Orson Welles right here. And that whole last shit right there was hard as fuck. But yo, that brings us to the end of today's video, ladies and gentlemen. If you like what you see, consider liking and leaving a comment down below. If you like what you see enough, please consider fucking subscribing because it's longer form. This video might be way long because it's two songs in one or two tracks in one. But normally the longer form video and analytical depth breakdown, those kind of things, that's how we get down. So if you like that, hit subscribe. Follow your boy on Instagram and on Twitter at The Third Earnest, just like the channel. Links are down in the description below. Hit up the Discord, also linked down in the description below. That's all that I got. We're done with Logic's album. The shit was fire. Now we're moving on to the next. Onward through the fucking fog. Like I always say at the end of all of my videos, I appreciate your time. I know that you can watch these videos with anybody, but you choose to do it here with me, and that shit means the world to me. But that's it. Go out there in the world, love and care for one another, love and care for each other. I'll catch everybody on the next video. Peace. I have the honor to be your obedient servant, A. Dot Burr.